So right now we're going to have a look at setting up outriggers on a small boat or trailer boat. Albeit this is quite a big small boat, the principle's still the same. I've got telescopic outriggers. These fit here nicely, as you can see underneath my combing. They're Real Rods outriggers made here in New Zealand, and they just telescope out nicely, line up the dots, and they lock in place. And then it's a simple case of dropping them onto my outrigger base up here. The walk around design allows me to easily get up to put the riggers in. I've just got a wee pin there. I'll just simply drop my rigger in place, twist it around till the hole lines up, drop the pin in. Now all I've got to do is clip on my halyard and I'm good to go. Now the trick with finding a point to secure your halyard is a point on the boat where they're nice and taut and tight when they're in the back position for when you're traveling or steaming, but they're also tight when they're out, so you're not having to readjust them. And I've played around on this boat. If I've got this handrail here with a bit of heavy duty bungee, you'll see there that everything's nice and tight. My outrigger can stay up when I'm steaming, when I'm ready to fish, twist the handle, boom. And that's ready to fish right now. Up and down she goes, nice and smoothly. Now you'll notice by having my fixing point up high here, there's no obstruction. So it doesn't interfere with the full walk around flow of the boat. Multiple hookups, or if you're putting a bait out over the front, no problem, you can take your rod, go straight to the front of the boat, and the outriggers aren't in your way. Now, I've just gone for the single halyard line. I find on trailer boats, if you've got multiple halyards, it can all get tangled, yet I've set it up in such a way that I can do all different styles of fishing with my outrigger. Now, firstly, I've just got a Blacks clip on here, so if I'm fishing for striped marlin, I like to give them a bit of a drop back, so I use a Blacks clip, rubber band into a Blacks clip, they can tap it. Tap the lure, it's going to drop back nicely to them. I do a lot of dead bait fishing, so of course I'm going to want a nice big drop back when I'm dead bait fishing. The Blacks clip's going to work fine for that. Now if I decide I want to have more than one line up in my rigger, I've just got one of these handy little Rupps clips here. Get that clipped on. So with just the one halyard, I've now got two outrigger clips. Now if I were fishing for blue marlin or yellowfin tuna, fish that I want to hook up on the bite, I don't want that drop back. So you want to be fishing with a tag line. Easily adaptable. Just simply slide my halyard down and I've got a tag line here that I can just poke up through my tag line return weight. I clip that on to the loop that I've got there and I can just slide that all the way up to the top, and that's what I tie onto my rubber band. I can set my lure out. That tag line weight goes up. If you're not familiar with how tag lines work, gets into the up position, and now I'm pulling directly off the rigger. So when a tuna or a marlin bites, boom, I've got two rubber bands on there, nice and hard. I hook up on the strike, rubber band breaks, and it's gonna return that tag line right back down here where I can grab it. If we haven't hooked up, I can get my rubber band back on there and get it back up quickly. Otherwise, it's out of the way and ready to go again. Now, the other style of game fishing I do a lot is bait and switch fishing. So again, I can change my outrigger setup to suit that too. If I loosen off my rigger a little, it's really easy with these cross-lock snaps that I've got on here. I can just unclip my Blacks clip, I can take my tagline return weight off, and I can switch out my Blacks clip for a roller troller. Now with the roller troller, I don't like fishing lures on them, but I can run a line through there with my teaser, out the back I raise a fish, hit the button on my electric reel, in comes my teaser, gets lifted up the rigger, doesn't knock out of the roller troller, and it just allows me to bait and switch easily by myself. So there's a few little tidbits there to how I've set up outriggers on my trailer boat. Remember the key things, finding that good point for your halyard, keep everything tensioned. With a single halyard, I'm able to diversify between tagline, Blacks clip, and roller troller. And another good point too is down here at the bottom, I've got a hell lock. So you don't get creep in your halyard, it's just a simple case of flicking that lever, locks it in place, and it's going nowhere. Haven't even used it yet. Can't wait to get out there.